The Global Positioning System is a space-based navigation system that provides location and time information in all weather conditions, anywhere on or near the Earth where there is an unobstructed line of sight to four or more GPS satellites. The system provides critical capabilities to military, civil, and commercial users around the world. The United States government created the system, maintains it, and makes it freely accessible to anyone with a GPS receiver. The U.S. began the GPS project in 1973 to overcome the limitations of previous navigation systems, integrating ideas from several predecessors, including a number of classified engineering design studies from the 1960s. The U.S. Department of Defense developed the system, which originally used 24 satellites. It became fully operational in 1995. Roger L. Easton, Ivan A. Getting and Bradford Parkinson are credited with inventing it. Advances in technology and new demands on the existing system have now led to efforts to modernize the GPS and implement the next generation of GPS, Block IIIA satellites and Next Generation Operational Control System. Announcements from Vice President Al Gore and the White House in 1998 initiated these changes. In 2000, the U.S. Congress authorized the modernization effort, GPS-3. In addition to GPS, other systems are in use or under development. The Russian Global Navigation Satellite System was developed contemporaneously with GPS, but suffered from incomplete coverage of the globe until the mid-2000s. There are also the planned European Union Galileo Positioning System, India's Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System, China's Beidou Navigation Satellite System, and the Japanese Quasi-Zenith Satellite System. History. The design of GPS is based partly on similar ground-based radio navigation systems, such as LORAN and the Deccan Navigator, developed in the early 1940s and used by the British Royal Navy during World War II. Predecessors in 1956. The German-American physicist Friedwart Winterberg proposed a test of general relativity, detecting time slowing in a strong gravitational field, using accurate atomic clocks placed in orbit inside artificial satellites. Calculations using general relativity determined that the clocks on the GPS satellites would be seen by the Earth's observers to run 38 microseconds faster per day, and this was corrected for in the design of GPS. The Soviet Union launched the first man-made satellite, Sputnik 1, in 1957. Two American physicists, William Geer and George Weiffenbach, at Johns Hopkins's Applied Physics Laboratory, decided to monitor Sputnik's radio transmissions. Within hours they realized that, because of the Doppler effect, they could pinpoint where the satellite was along its orbit. The director of the APL gave them access to their UNIVAC to do the heavy calculations required. The next spring, Frank McClure, the deputy director of the APL, asked Geer and Weiffenbach to investigate the inverse problem, pinpointing the user's location, given that of the satellite. This led them and APL to develop the transit system. In 1959, ARPA also played a role in transit. The first satellite navigation system, Transit, used by the United States Navy, was first successfully tested in 1960. It used a constellation of five satellites and could provide a navigational fix approximately once per hour. In 1967, the U.S. Navy developed the Timation satellite that proved the ability to place accurate clocks in space, a technology required by GPS. In the 1970s, the ground-based Timaga navigation system, based on phase comparison of signal transmission from pairs of stations, became the first worldwide radio navigation system. Limitations of these systems drove the need for a more universal navigation solution with greater accuracy. While there were wide needs for accurate navigation in military and civilian sectors, almost none of those were seen as justification for the billions of dollars it would cost in research, development, deployment, and operation for a constellation of navigation satellites. During the Cold War arms race, the nuclear threat to the existence of the United States was the one need that did justify this cost in the view of the United States Congress. This deterrent effect is why GPS was funded. It is also the reason for the ultra-secrecy at that time. The nuclear triad consisted of the United States Navy's submarine-launched ballistic missiles along with United States Air Force strategic bombers and intercontinental ballistic missiles. Considered vital to the nuclear deterrence posture, accurate determination of the SLBM launch position was a force multiplier. Precise navigation would enable United States ballistic missile submarines to get an accurate fix of their positions before they launched their SLBMs. The USAF, with two-thirds of the nuclear triad, also had requirements for a more accurate and reliable navigation system. The Navy and Air Force were developing their own technologies in parallel to solve what was essentially the same problem, to increase the survivability of ICBMs. There was a proposal to use mobile launch platforms, and so the need to fix the launch position had similarity to the SLBM situation. In 1960, the Air Force proposed a radio navigation system called Mosaic that was essentially a 3D LORAN. A follow-on study, Project 57, was worked in 1963, and it was in this study that the GPS concept was born. That same year, the concept was pursued as Project 621B, which had many of the attributes that you now see in GPS, and promised increased accuracy for Air Force bombers as well as ICBMs. Updates from the Navy transit system were too slow for the high speeds of Air Force operation. The Naval Research Laboratory continued advancements with automation satellites, first launched in 1967, and with the third one in 1974 carrying the first atomic clock into orbit. Another important predecessor to GPS came from a different branch of the United States military. In 1964, the United States Army orbited its first sequential collation of range satellite used for geodetic surveying. The SECOR system included three ground-based transmitters from known locations that would send signals to the satellite transponder in orbit. A fourth ground-based station, at an undetermined position, could then use those signals to fix its location precisely. The last SECOR satellite was launched in 1969. Decades later, during the early years of GPS, civilian surveying became one of the first fields to make use of the new technology. Because surveyors could reap benefits of signals from the less-than-complete GPS constellation years before it was declared operational, GPS can be thought of as an evolution of the SECOR system, where the ground-based transmitters have been migrated into orbit. Development with these parallel developments in the 1960s. It was realized that a superior system could be developed by synthesizing the best technologies from 621B, transit, automation, and SECOR in a multi-service program. During Labor Day weekend in 1973, a meeting of about 12 military officers at the Pentagon discussed the creation of a defense navigation satellite system. It was at this meeting that the real synthesis that became GPS was created. Later that year, the DNSS program was named NavStar, or Navigation System Using Timing and Ranging, with the individual satellites being associated with the name NavStar. A more fully encompassing name was used to identify the constellation of NavStar satellites, NavStar GPS. 10 Block I prototype satellites were launched between 1978 and 1985. After Korean Airlines Flight 007, a Boeing 747 carrying 269 people, was shot down in 1983 after straying into the USSR's prohibited airspace. In the vicinity of Sakhalin and Monoron Islands, President Ronald Reagan issued a directive making GPS freely available for civilian use. Once it was sufficiently developed as a common good, the first Block 2 satellite was launched on February 14, 1989, and the 24th satellite was launched in 1994. The GPS program cost at this point, not including the cost of the user equipment, but including the costs of the satellite launches, has been estimated at about $5 billion. Roger L. Easton is widely credited as the primary inventor of GPS. Initially, the highest quality signal was reserved for military use, and the signal available for civilian use was intentionally degraded. This changed with President Bill Clinton signing a policy directive in 1996 to turn off selective availability in May 2000 to provide the same precision to civilians that was afforded to the military. The directive was proposed by the U.S. Secretary of Defense, William Perry. Because of the widespread growth of differential GPS services to improve civilian accuracy and eliminate the U.S. military advantage. Moreover, the U.S. military was actively developing technologies to deny GPS service to potential adversaries on a regional basis. Since its deployment, the U.S. has implemented several improvements to the GPS service, including new signals for civil use and increased accuracy and integrity for all users, all the while maintaining compatibility with existing GPS equipment. Modernization of the satellite system has been an ongoing initiative by the U.S. Department of Defense through a series of satellite acquisitions to meet the growing needs of the military, civilians, and the commercial market. As of early 2015, high-quality, FAA-grade, standard positioning service GPS receivers provide horizontal accuracy of better than 3.5 meters. Although many factors such as receiver quality and atmospheric issues can affect this accuracy, GPS is owned and operated by the United States government as a national resource. The Department of Defense is the steward of GPS. Interagency GPS Executive Board oversaw GPS policy matters from 1996 to 2004. After that, the National Space-Based Positioning, Navigation and Timing Executive Committee was established by presidential directive in 2004 to advise and coordinate federal departments and agencies on matters concerning the GPS and related systems. The executive committee is chaired jointly by the Deputy Secretaries of Defense and Transportation. Its membership includes equivalent-level officials from the Departments of State, Commerce, and Homeland Security, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and NASA. Components of the Executive Office of the President participate as observers to the Executive Committee, and the FCC Chairman participates as a liaison. The U.S. Department of Defense is required by law to maintain a standard positioning service that will be available on a continuous, worldwide basis, and develop measures to prevent hostile use of GPS and its augmentations without unduly disrupting or degrading civilian uses. Timeline and modernization. In 1972, the USAF Central Inertial Guidance Test Facility conducted developmental flight tests of two prototype GPS receivers over White Sands Missile Range, using ground-based pseudo-satellites. In 1978, the first experimental Block I GPS satellite was launched. In 1983, after Soviet interceptor aircraft shot down the civilian airliner KAL-007 that strayed into prohibited airspace because of navigational errors, killing all 269 people on board, U.S. President Ronald Reagan announced that GPS would be made available for civilian uses once it was completed, although it had been previously published in Navigation magazine that the CA code would be available to civilian users. By 1985, 10 more experimental Block I satellites had been launched to validate the concept. Beginning in 1988, command and control of these satellites was transitioned from Onizuka AFS, K, California to the 2nd Satellite Control Squadron located at Falcon Air Force Station in Colorado Springs, Colorado. On February 14, 1989, the first modern Block II satellite was launched. The Gulf War from 1990 to 1991 was the first conflict in which the military widely used GPS. In 1991, a project to create a miniature GPS receiver successfully ended, replacing the previous 50-pound military receivers with a 2.75-pound handheld receiver. In 1992, the second space wing, which originally managed the system, was inactivated and replaced by the 50th space wing. By December 1993, GPS achieved initial operational capability, indicating a full constellation was available and providing the standard positioning service. Full operational capability was declared by Air Force Space Command in April 1995, signifying full availability of the military's secure, precise positioning service. In 1996, recognizing the importance of GPS to civilian users as well as military users, U.S. President Bill Clinton issued a policy directive declaring GPS a dual-use system and establishing an interagency GPS executive board to manage it as a national asset. In 1998, United States Vice President Al Gore announced plans to upgrade GPS with two new civilian signals for enhanced use of accuracy and reliability, particularly with respect to aviation safety, and in 2000 the United States Congress authorized the effort, referring to it as GPS-3. On May 2, 2000, selective availability was discontinued as a result of the 1996 executive order, allowing users to receive a non-degraded signal globally. In 2004, the United States government signed an agreement with the European Community establishing cooperation related to GPS and Europe's planned Galileo system. In 2004, United States President George W. Bush updated the national policy and replaced the executive board with the National Executive Committee for Space-Based Positioning, Navigation, and Timing. November 2004, Qualcomm announced successful tests of assisted GPS for mobile phones. In 2005, the first modernized GPS satellite was launched and began transmitting a second civilian signal for enhanced user performance. On September 14, 2007, the aging mainframe-based ground segment control system was transferred to the new Architecture Evolution Plan. On May 19, 2009, the United States Government Accountability Office issued a report warning that some GPS satellites could fail as soon as 2010. On May 21, 2009, the Air Force Space Command allayed fears of GPS failure, saying, "There's only a small risk we will not continue to exceed our performance standard." On January 11, 2010, an update of ground control systems caused a software incompatibility with 8,000 to 10,000 military receivers manufactured by a division of Trimble Navigation Limited of Sunnyvale, Calif. On February 25, 2010, the U.S. Air Force awarded the contract to develop the GPS Next Generation Operational Control System to improve accuracy and availability of GPS navigation signals, and serve as a critical part of GPS modernization. Awards on February 10, 1993, the National Aeronautic Association selected the GPS team as winners of the 1992 Robert J. Collier Trophy, the nation's most prestigious aviation award. This team combines researchers from the Naval Research Laboratory, the USAF, the Aerospace Corporation, Rockwell International Corporation, and IBM Federal Systems Company. The citation honors them for the most significant development for safe and efficient navigation and surveillance of air and spacecraft since the introduction of radio navigation 50 years ago. Two GPS developers received the National Academy of Engineering Charles Stark Draper Prize for 2003. Ivan Getting, Emeritus President of the Aerospace Corporation and an engineer at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, established the basis for GPS, improving on the World War II land-based radio system called LORAN. Bradford Parkinson, Professor of Aeronautics and Astronautics at Stanford University, conceived the present satellite-based system in the early 1960s and developed it in conjunction with the U.S. Air Force. Parkinson served 21 years in the Air Force, from 1957 to 1978, and retired with the rank of colonel. GPS developer Roger L. Easton received the National Medal of Technology on February 13, 2006. Francis X. Kane was inducted into the U.S. Air Force Space and Missile Pioneers Hall of Fame at Lackland AFB, San Antonio, Texas, March 2, 2010 for his role in space technology development and the engineering design concept of GPS conducted as part of Project 621B. In 1998, GPS technology was inducted into the Space Foundation Space Technology Hall of Fame. On October 4, 2011, the International Astronautical Federation awarded the Global Positioning System its 60th Anniversary Award, nominated by IAF member, the American Institute for Aeronautics and Astronautics. The IAF Honors and Awards Committee recognized the uniqueness of the GPS program and the exemplary role it has played in building international collaboration for the benefit of humanity.